of your knowledge in a very systematic way. So I'll give you, one or two definitions so you can please, just the key points you can write down so that you know what research is and what research is not all about. So right now, the research is a systematic, approach in obtaining and confirming a new and reliable knowledge. So basically, when you talk about research, it talks about all the disciplines. And if you take the raw information in a very raw thing, you will not be able to comprehend the thing. So in a research, you have to culminate all the basic knowledge together, and you have to organize it and classify it in a particular way, and so that you can be able to infer the things in a nice way. So I mean, just wait in the time. We are sorry for this because I think the PPT was not received. Anyone who knows about the question? So he is on a perfect thing that literature review is basically gauging about the work done already could be in India and could be in a global perspective. Now there are certain things which are important from the Indian point of view, so the most stress would be on recovering and reviewing the literature in India. And certain things, since we are living in a globalized world and integrated economy, so certain education could be important in the global perspective also. So literature review is one thing in research which has got 90% of the literature. So whenever you start with any kind of a research paper, the basic perspective and premise will depend upon your literature review. Why literature review? Because literature review, one, will give you the concepts which have already been covered. And of course, when you start from the chronological order, like say back in 90s, you are starting with a research paper, then what was the concept which was given by the earlier researchers? And of course, if you move ahead in the life, and there's a timeline moving ahead in the future, so maybe the results which were concluded in the year 1990, they are not standing now. And of course, in 2017, the concept must have been evolved. So, the conceptual involvement is also very important from the research perspective, as far as the India and global perspective is concerned. Why? Because over the years, the concepts, they evolve, the concepts, they go, move, a sea change. So, this is what the research is all about. So, you keep adding to what the earlier researchers have done. But your basic aim in the research should be doing something new. So, please make this in quote. Whenever you are doing any kind of research, your hypothesis formulation, your objective formulation should add something which is innovative in nature, which is new in nature, and could be an extension of the previous study. But yes, whatever you do, it has to be on your own. There should not be a plagiarized text. If you go and move on a plagiarized text, then could be your reputation will be zero. That you are not doing something new on your own, you are taking the conceptual framework of somebody else, just trying to paraphrase the things and just trying to put in your own words the same research. But there are certain softwares which are there, like Turnitin and Turnitout, which is going to even depict the document, how you have edited that document, and the research is not in your name, the research was previously owned by somebody else. So, these are the key points which I am explaining. You should keep these in mind. That whatever you do, maybe one line is yours, but it should be yours. So please give maximum importance to the literature review. Literature review will give you the research gap. The research gap will give you your research objective and your research definition and your research question. Now, if research, the literature review is not done in depth, then all these things will be not of any kind of paramount importance. So you must take this in mind that literature review has to be chronological, that is year-wise, then how the conceptual things have covered, how the things have been evolved, what is the new things which the researchers have previously done, and what is now which you want to do. Maybe, for example, there are certain studies which are available in the developed market, but it is not there for the developing market. So you must develop that kind of a framework which is most important for the developing countries, not for the developed countries. So that is the research. Like, for example, I did a research on the stock market. The stock market and the commodity market are not that the informationally effective as they are there in the developed countries. So I tried to cover that kind of aspect which was not covered in India, which is not there in India, and you have to, whenever you are formulating your research objective and questions, you have to build the research gap, number one. You have to do and make the rationale of your studies, number two. Whenever you go and take some interviews and you give your research topic, so the first thing is that they will ask this, what is your research topic? Second question, why did you choose it? Number three, if you have chosen it, what is the reason behind it? So, that is the answer of a rational brain. Like, for example, I gave you the concept of the stock market and the commodity market which I did. So, I built up a rational. And in your research studies also, it could be an MPhil or a PhD, you have to write that what was the reason of taking of your these concepts were given to me by my own guide, and so I'm giving it to you. So if these things you keep in mind, the future is yours, and you would start loving research, and there's no limit to your search, sky's the limit for you. So I started the concept of research. The research was about collecting the structured information in a very meaningful way. Number two, I gave you the concept of what research is and what's not about a research is. Any accidental recovery is not a research. Number two, usually the research takes a particular phenomenon. You understand why? Anyone? Why a research takes a particular phenomenon? Anyone? Now see, any research which you start, any research which you make, it has to follow a particular phenomena because it is based on a theoretical background. So research emerges from a theory. So before you take up any topic, just read extensively about it. For example, these are the new topics, instability in the organization. You understand what is instability in the organization? Anyone? What is instability in the organization? Suppose this is the topic which I am giving you to write the research paper. But there is no instability in your organization. Everyone is very civilized. It's the opposite of civilization, that is, you are very polished and good in your behavior, the civility. And if you are not in cooperation with these things, you are called as an incivil person. So incivility in the organization is increasing. So if I ask you, that you have to do a research on this topic, that what is the reason behind rise in incivility in the organization, and what is the probable effect of that incivility on the performance of the organization? So this is the research question which I am giving you. How do you start with this topic? I mean, does it relate the research to the reality? We then would comprehend things much nicely. If the question is, what is the impact of incivility, or wrong behavior, or maybe a bullying behavior of your mate or your colleague onto your performance? I mean, you have to think about this research topic. Then there are certain things which come to your mind. Maybe you feel depressed. Maybe there's a behavioral change in you. Maybe you are always on an emotional outburst of your emotions. You are not feeling happy with the organization. Then if you are not feeling happy with the organization, staying here, probably you look for some other organization. And probably the turnover of the employees in case of the incivility is increasing. So, these things can be standardized. These things can be measured. Because there is a theory behind it. There is a behavioral theory behind it. So that means I can always say, if I ask you this question, what is the impact of wrong behavior of your colleagues onto your performance, immediately you will say, you will not like to work there. So this is what is the question which I am talking about here, that usually it takes a particular phenomenon. Why do I say this? Because everyone has a theoretical backdrop to it. Everyone says that to disrespect elders is a wrong thing. Because it is again following your usual phenomenon. Whatever you are researching. And of course you should keep this in mind, that there are so many aspects which you can deeply study. It could be qualitative, it could be quantitative. So I will be talking about these later, and then I move on with the presentation. And the next thing which I am talking about here is that the collecting or reliable information in case of research is also very important. You cannot be depending on any of the source to collect the information. The information sources have to be authentic in nature. The information sources have to be correct in nature if you are dealing with the secondary data. The secondary data is a data which has already been collected by the researchers with their own mindset, with their own objective. But since you are doing an exploratory study, the study which has not done before, you are trying to frame your own objective, you have your own mindset. In that case, you have to make a question yourself.
What is the impact of this?
If they are asking you which soap you are using, maybe you are using a very low grade soap, but you will often say, I am using Pure, I am using S quality, I am using a luxury soap. So, this makes the information very conditioned. This makes the information broad. Why? Because the respondents are not in that spirit, or they are not giving the correct amount of information, which affects your data, which affects your analytics.